Dear students, let us do problems on latent heat. This is a solved example 12.4. When 0.15 kg of ice of 0 degree centigrade is mixed with 0.30 kg of water at 50 degree centigrade in a container, the resulting temperature is 6.7 degree centigrade. Calculate the heat of fusion of ice. Specific heat of water is given here. Now here, let us write this as an equation. 0.15 kg ice, and that is at a temperature 0 degree centigrade. It is mixed with 0.30 kg, this is water, and this is at temperature 50 degree centigrade. And by adding these two, what we are getting? We will be getting water only. How much? See, 0.15, 0.3, 0.45 kg water. And the resulting temperature is given 6.7 degree centigrade. So here, which is at higher temperature, this will lose the heat energy. And which is at lower temperature, this gains the heat energy. So as usual, we will be writing here like this: heat lost, and here heat gained. So which will be the losing the heat? Which is at higher temperature loses the heat? So water. And which will gain? Ice. Ice will gain. And previously we did such problems, and whether heat lost or gained, the formula we used was delta Q is equal to M S delta T. We used this formula. Delta Q is equal to M S delta T. Various is specific heat of the given substance. But here, we should, in addition to this, we need another equation also, and that is equation for latent heat. Q is equal to M capital L. Actually, the latent heat is defined as L is equal to Q by M, or from that we get Q is equal to ML. See, what is the difference between these two equations? See, when there is change in temperature, we use this equation. And when heat energy is supplied without change in temperature, then we use this expression. Now, on heat lost side, okay, this is at higher temperature and this will lose the heat. Okay, let us write this: 0.30 kg water. So this, after losing heat, it reaches a temperature of 6.7 degree centigrade. Initially it was at 50 degree centigrade. Now it will reach 6.7 degree centigrade temperature. So there is change in temperature. So we will be using this formula. So here delta Q is equal to M S delta T. Mass is 0.30 kg. Specific heat of water is 4186 and change in temperature 50 minus 6.7. So we get this much value over. Now let us go to this side, heat gained. Now we should start with 0.15 kg ice, and this ice is at 0 degree centigrade. See, first what happens, ice is at 0 degree centigrade. At the same temperature, first ice melts into water. Only change of state, only change at the same temperature. First we supply some heat energy to convert 0.15 kg ice into 0.15 kg water at the same temperature. And for change of state, what heat we supply? Latent heat. And for that purpose, we use this formula. Okay. Now, after, now only its temperature changes. Now its temperature changes from 0 to, what is the resultant temperature? 6.7 degree centigrade. So here we use the formula ML because it is latent heat, and here we use the formula MS delta T. So here what is the mass? 0.15 kg and L value, that we don't know. Here, see here, it is ice is becoming water, and this is called as melting or fusion. So here we write LF, and that LF value we are going to find. Now, from here to here, there is change in temperature. Mass 0.15 kg, specific heat of water is 4186, and change in temperature 6.7 minus 0. We got this much value. Now by principle of calorimetry, heat lost is equal to heat gained. See, here we use by principle of calorimetry, or we can say method of mixtures. So heat lost is equal to heat gained. So what is the heat lost? 54376.14 joules. Now heat gained, see here it is 0.15 LF plus here 4206.93. So from this we get LF value as, we get this value. Now let us look at solid example 12.5. Calculate the heat required to convert 3 kg of ice at minus 12 degree centigrade kept in a calorimeter to steam at 100 degree centigrade at atmospheric pressure. So the values are given. So now where from we have to start? We are given 3 kg of ice. 3 kg ice. And that is at minus 12 degree centigrade. since this is at minus 12 degree centigrade, so when you supply heat energy, first temperature increases until 0 degree centigrade. So 3 kg ice, 0 degree centigrade. So the heat energy used. So here there is change in temperature. There is change in temperature. And for that purpose, the formula we use is Ms delta T. Now, after reaching 0 degree centigrade, until the total ice is converted into water, there will be no change in temperature, only change of state. Only change of state. And here the heat supplied is called as latent heat. For that the formula is ML, here F fusion. Now after becoming 3 kg water at 0 degree centigrade, see, let us look at the problem. So it is going up to steam at 100 degree centigrade. Okay. Now, first there will be only rise in temperature. 3 kg water, 100 degree centigrade. First there is a rise in temperature. After rise in temperature, for this the formula is, since there is change in temperature, Ms delta T. And now it absorbing the heat energy, the boiling water is converted into, see, 3 kg water at 100 degree centigrade, but here steam. Okay, this 3 kg water is converted into 3 kg steam, but the temperature is same temperature, but there is change of state. For that purpose, the heat supplied is called as latent heat, and the formula we use is ML. And here water to steam means latent heat of vaporization. Latent heat of vaporization. Now see here, M, mass is 3 kg, specific heat of ice, it is given 2100, change in temperature 0 minus 12, we get this much heat energy. Next, here mass is 3 kg, LF, latent heat of fusion, that is given here 3.35 into 10 to the power of 5, we get this much value. Now mass 3 kg, specific heat of water 4186, change in temperature 100 minus 0. We get this much. Next, mass 3 kg, LV. It is given 22.56 into 10 power 5. And that is equal to, we get this much value. Okay, now what is asked here? Calculate the heat required. So by adding all the three, we get heat required by adding the four terms. We get this much answer. Now this is the third problem from our textbook. How much steam at 100 degree centigrade is to be passed into water of mass 100 grams at 20 degree centigrade to raise its temperature by 5 degree centigrade? See, how much steam means, say, mkg steam, and it is at 100 degree centigrade. This is added to water. How much? 100 grams. So here, let us take grams only. M grams. 100 grams water. You are adding M grams of steam at 100 degree centigrade to 100 grams of water, and which is at 20 degree centigrade. So what is the final result? The final result is, see, the mass will be M plus 100 and steam is added to water, means we will be having water only. And now about temperature. Its temperature, you should send steam until the temperature rises by 5 degree centigrade. It means its temperature is 20. So it should become 25. So now, see, which is at high temperature loses the heat, and which is at low temperature gains the heat. Now we write here heat lost. Here let us write heat gained. So who loses the heat? Steam. Here water. Okay, now steam, how much m grams of steam is there? And it is at 100 degree centigrade. So this is added to water, and what is the final result? You are getting water only. So this must be condensed to water. So initially what happens? There will be no change in temperature, just a change of state. M grams of steam becomes M grams of water at the same temperature. And afterwards only temperature changes. What is the final temperature? 25. Now, this side, what is happening? See, you have taken 100 grams of water, and it is at 20 degree centigrade. After mixing the steam to that, what is happening? Simply, its temperature is being increased, that's all. Its temperature is increased. Right. Here, same temperature, the heat energy supplied is utilized just for change of state. So the heat supplied here is called as latent heat, and here from steam to water means this is vaporization or condensation. So here Q is equal to M L V. mass is m grams. LV, vaporization, say latent heat of steam is 540 calories per gram. So 540 calories per gram. So here m is in grams and here calories per gram. Gram gets cancelled, you are left with calories. Now here there is change in temperature. So the formula we use is m s delta t, mass m kg, specific heat of water is 4186, change in temperature 100 minus 25. That's all. Now this side. So here there is change in temperature, therefore the formula is ms delta t. Mass is 100 grams, specific heat of water is 4, but here we should not use 4186, this is SI value here, CGS value, the specific heat, it is given, specific heat of water is 1 calorie per gram. One calorie per gram here. Okay, here specific heat of water is 1 calorie per gram and change in temperature 25 minus 20. Now by method of mixtures, by method of mixtures, heat lost is equal to heat gained. Heat lost is 540m plus 100, here 75m. Is equal to, here 25 minus 20 means 500. Or m is equal to 500 by 615. That is equal to, we get 0.813 grams. Twenty grams of steam at 100 degree centigrade is passed into 100 grams of ice at 0 degree centigrade. Find the resultant temperature. So when steam is added to ice, we will be getting water and the mass will be 100 plus 20, 120 grams water, and that its resultant temperature is asked, TFC, final temperature. That is asked. Now, which is at higher temperature loses the heat? So, steam is at higher temperature, therefore, it will lose the heat, and this is at lower temperature. So it will gain the heat. Okay, now see 20 grams of steam, 20 grams of steam at 100 degree centigrade. This is going to become water. So first steam is condensed into water at the same temperature, and afterwards temperature rises to a final temperature. Here our ice is gaining. How much ice? 100 grams of ice at 0 degree centigrade. And this is going to become water. So first it gains heat energy, but the temperature doesn't change, just a change of state. Ice becomes water, but the temperature same. And only thereafter its temperature rises to what temperature? A final temperature. Now since here there is no rise in temperature, the heat expression for heat is ML, latent heat. Steam to what means? Vaporization. And here there is change in temperature, therefore MS delta T. Now mass 20 grams. Steam value L steam 540. Here mass 20 grams. S value 1 calorie per gram. Change in temperature 100 minus TF. This is, so this TF value will be between 0 and 100. Therefore here we should write 100 minus TF. 100 minus TF. Okay, this side at same temperature there is change in state, that is latent heat, and the formula is ML, mass 100 grams. And here ice becoming water, therefore here we write what is this called, fusion, LF, and that's value is 80 calories per gram. And here there is change in temperature, MS delta T, mass 100 grams, specific heat 1, change in temperature 0 to TF, TF minus 0. Now by method of mixtures, heat lost is equal to heat gained. Heat lost here how much? And here how much? And on this side 8000 plus TF. Now let us move this to that side. 10,800 minus 8000 is equal to 100 TF. And here one more thing, 20 into 100, 2000 plus 2000, and here minus 20 TF, here becomes plus 20 TF.